It's sad. Because just how what we went through. You see, what is happening now makes one feel that you see, we have to go back to the basics. Some of the government policies did not help us. They didn't help us at all. One of the policies just changing curriculum almost every time. You wouldn't even know where to start. Loading the curriculum so much that there's not enough time to spend in teaching this the subjects for the student to really excel in it. Too many things have been loaded into the curriculum. And another thing is, teacher training has been relegated to the background. You cannot have good education without a standard teacher training procedure. A lot of the teacher training institutes are no longer there. And this, our teachers need to be trained. For it's a profession. They forget that teaching is a profession. That people who go into it need to be properly trained. Methodology of teaching. Some of those things, they just go to the class and be talking. They taught us. I did postgraduate diploma in education. I passed through teacher training. And every step, how to train a small child, how to do the psychology of the children you are teaching. So many things go into teaching, which is not there now. We are not giving enough attention to the training of teachers. As a result, many of them, they just pass by. They just want to, we are looking for other jobs, but let us just do this for the meantime. A temporary thing. But thank God that they started the Teachers Council, registering professional teachers, so that we can professionalize, we can professionalize teaching. Let all those who pick it as a profession staying in it. And, well, they are now recognizing teachers and giving them better, at least Baba Batonje did that for us. And he was able to raise the scale, the salary scale of teachers to the extent that some of them are now stable. They have been stabilized. They know that it is their profession and they stay in it and they grow in it. So, education nowadays, we are just thanking God for how far we have reached, and we are praying that we have a good educational policy. We had one that we were following, only we derailed along the way. This national policy of education that we are following, when I was actively teaching, there was space there for vocational training. Anybody at a stage, you can move into the vocational aspect. Those who want to go for that in university, all those things, they are no longer taken seriously. You remember when you were in school, we had a technical department. And in that technical department, you were making things. Some of the things you made is what I'm still using now for spreading clothes. You know, that I will show you. Okay. Then you made openers. You made different things in that technical workshop. A lot of the schools have no technical workshop anymore. In the first instance, most of the materials they bought for us, the government provided, have been stolen. Not enough security in schools. They stole all of them. So a lot of them, they are not replaced. Just for some time, we had this technical education for our students, and most of them are no longer functioning. So I pray that our students don't start looking for shortcuts to success. In your own days, I remember you used to read. Reading, the library was your friend. You had a press club, and that press club made you what you are today. But many of these things are no longer as they used to be. We really need to go back and furnish our schools with good libraries, good teachers, things that will make them really want to read and pass their exams, not for people to help them. The issue of special schools did not arise in those days. Now the parents will be paying for their students to do the exams in special centers. They don't get it. You know, children don't really read like in the past to pass exams. They relax. There's too much relaxation. And commitment is very necessary. Where you have committed teachers, you see the students doing well. Because their aim will always be for their children to surpass, for their children to excel. But when things are not going properly, you see that the students, you will see it in the performance of the students. You see it when they don't perform well anymore. But thank God, like in Ogun State now, they take it. Ogun State does not joke with education. I thank God for that. Both the public schools, the private schools, are all working very hard for students to do well. We have a National Association of Proprietors of Private Schools where we really need to see that we raise the standard of education. Just like in the ANCOPS, we have an association of principals of secondary schools. They too, they are working in the public sector. So we all work together to see how much we can do to raise the level of education. And thank God when we have commissioners of education that know what they are talking about, you will see that things are moving. I'm happy in Ogun State, where I am, can see that things are moving in the right direction. Okay. And I pray that it continues so.
What advice, Mark, for how to take care of our youths of today?
Our youths, so you can see the confusion we are in. The youths cannot be separated from their background. We cannot separate the youths we have from the homes they come from. If the youths are not doing well, let's go to the basics. It starts from the family. It starts from the family. What to do to bring our youths to order now is to face family units. A lot of divorce has affected many homes. We women are no longer patient enough to pass through difficult times. The men, some of them, are not playing their roles as good fathers in the home. And produce so many children. Let's start with birth control. A man with so many children, how is he going to train all of them? When, right from the beginning, Daddy and I, we decided we are going to have only 4 children. And those 4 children, we train up to the university level. See what so many homes have. Let's start with the fathers who want 3 or 4 wives. Each wife will want to have 3 or 4 children now. Is he able to cope? And so it starts from the home. The home that is not cohesive, where responsibilities are pushed to into the hands of one person. We never heard that type of. I told you my father had 9 children. He was concentrating on training the boys, which he did. But when he saw that we girls were not going to sit down doing nothing, I picked it up again. I went into teaching profession. My sister went into medicine. The other, the third one went into computer. When computer was just started coming up. So our father gave us good educational training so that we would not suffer in our husband's home. We would be partners with our husband. Also being able to be productive, to earn something, not to leave all the responsibility on the shoulders of the husband. So when we have husbands and wives who are able to share their body and also take their children seriously, those children will not go into evil ways. They won't produce Yahoo boys, Yahoo girls. See the life of Chindi Mana. Look at the girl that was said to have killed her sugar daddy boyfriend. Look at that girl from her youth. She said, I think from the age of 2 or so, the parents had had separated and she was staying with her uncle in Moshi. From there, she's staying with her father. The mother is somewhere else. Can you see the life that that girl grew in? Of course, she fell into wrong hands. Friends that were able to influence her negative. So if the home does its job well, youths will not go astray. All the youths that we have now produced, many of them are tigers. You have to look at what is happening in the north. Imagine this. They go about begging for food. Into what type of youth will those imaginaries grow? They are the ones causing problems now. Because if they have no good source of income, there's no job. Are they going to be begging for life? So they join the bandits. And they're disturbing society. That is why when I was young, my father would say, don't forget your cousins. Because any talk back, only madam, you talk, you say, so that my children will have peace of mind. The children of their brothers, sisters, and everything, you better let us start helping them. Otherwise, you won't have peace of mind. And so, we started helping cousins, nephews, anybody that you must bring somebody. And today, now, those ones that we have trained, they too are training other people. So youths now have been destroyed by the family foundation.